Okay, hi everyone. I'm Beato from Telenav Romania, and today I will present to you the Improve OSM project. That's an amazing project that we have developed in the last couple of months. We all know that OSM is an awesome map, but in general has a good quality and coverage, but there are still some places that are missing from the map, including one-way attributes and also turn restrictions. Manually gathering the missing element takes time and it is not so scalable. So keeping this in mind, we have started to analyze our huge amount of GPS data, and we came up with a suite of tools that identifies elements that are missing from the map and transforms to small tasks that can be solved by the community. So what is Improve OSM? Improve OSM is based on high volume of probe data and OSM. First, a little bit history regarding this project. This project has started as a Learning Friday project where we were focused on how to determine ways and neighborhoods that are missing from OSM. The results of this analysis were released last year in September via the missing roads tools. Then the next detection was focused on detecting double digitized way that are not present in OSM, and this was released under the name of traffic flow direction. And last year in December we released the last detection that were related to turn restrictions. At a height level view, our components can be described by the following diagram. You see there that we use the OSM map and we use the probe data. These two data sets goes to the Improve OSM engine. The Improve OSM engine is composed by a big data analyzer component that has three main components: the missing roads, the traffic flow direction, and turn restriction. The result of each of these components is inserted then to the corresponding database, and it's available via the missing road service, the traffic flow direction service, and the turn restriction service. These results can be visualized using one of the Improve OSM community tools. We have an Improve OSM JOSM plugin, the Improve OSM web application, and later we have also integrated the Improve OSM tools with the ID editor. So the missing roads component's purpose is to identify roads that are missing from the map. After analyzing our first results, we also notified that besides missing roads, we also found missing parking lots, missing houses, and in many cases we found that not only the main roads is missing from the map, as in this case, but also the houses, and again the houses does not have any tags and so on. So the missing roads workflow can be mainly characterized by the following three steps. At the first step, we took the continental PBS and take out from this only the highways and waterways along with other attributes. We keep only the identifiers of these ways along with the geometry. At the second step, we have a filling component, and that component combines from the OSM map the OSM tiles. And the last step, we took our probe data, and in the processor component, we compute the probe data tiles. And finally, at the overlay component, we took the probe data tiles and OSM tiles, and we get the tiles that are missing from the map. Now, some interesting facts about our main steps. So at the first step, when we take only the highway components, but lately we get a lot of interest from the community, and also the other keys were added, like golf, waterway, natural, and so on. These were supplied via the feedback form to us. At the second workflow step, we use a filling algorithm to generate the tiles. We only generate tiles from zoom level 18, and we generate for all the OSM roads and continental waters. In order to capture all the situation where the GPS is jumping a lot, we also generate buffer tiles. Okay, at step three, on the processor components, besides generating tiles, again for zoom level 80, we also compute average speed for each tile and determine if a tile contains pros from the start, middle, end, or of the trail. This step is important in order to be able to determine if a tile probably contains road or parking attributes. Okay, on the overlay component, we take the probe tiles and the map tiles, and the tiles that are not present on the map are the missing roads. We determine the tile type. We determine road, parking, mixed, water, and path. And we also use a clustering algorithm to discard invalid tiles. And we filter out also tiles that are generated on top of continental waters. We had a lot of tiles that are on waters. Probably our users use the GPS navigation also when they are on boat. Okay, the next component is the traffic flow direction. The purpose of this component is to identify double digitized roads in OSM that, based on our analysis, are one ways. This component can be described by the following workflow. At the first step, we use the speed profile results. The speed profile is another Telenav component, and basically the results contains for each way a speed and a number of tracks for each direction. At this step, we compute the trail counts per direction. We compute also the percent of trails per direction and the result of the ways that satisfy the, these two component thing is the one-way processor. At the second step, we took the OSM data and extract all the highways, and this way we generate some kind of map data. And at the overlay component, we took all the map data generated with the one-way processor candidates, and we get the probable one-ways. Some interesting thing regarding our component steps. At the one-way processor, basically we do the following things, and if one way passes step one and two, then we compute the confidence level based on the trail count. We need to introduce the confidence count because we get some false positives and somehow to indicate what would be the most important results to be added back to the map. At step three, at the overlay component, besides joining map data with one-way candidates, we also filter out service roads, roundabouts, private roads, existing one-ways, or deleted roads. This filter is executed periodically to remove deleted ways from our results, since the first speed profile component is run only periodically and it is not run, let's say, each month. And we somehow need to eliminate results that are not longer valid from our data set. The purpose of the turn restriction component is to identify turn restrictions that are missing from the map. This component workflow can be described by the following diagram. At the first step, we take the map matcher output. The map matcher is another component and basically returns a list of segments and along with a list of trails that were on those segments. Here we have three components, the intersection count, the turn restriction model, and the turn restriction finalizer. At the end of this process, we get a list of turn restriction candidates. At step two, we took from the PBF the existing turn restrictions from the map. And the last step, we also here have a filter that filters out the existing turn restrictions from our candidate turn restrictions. Some interesting facts about our smaller components. At the intersection counts, we identify all the intersections from OSM and overlay this with the map matching result. This way, we will get all the intersections from OSM with the number of traces that pass throughout each intersection. at the turn restriction model. This model purpose is to identify the turn restrictions, and this is based on some minimal number of tracks that a turn needs to have in order to be considered to be a valid one. And in the finalizer component, we identify the type of the turn restriction based on the geometry. Currently, we identify the following types: no left turn, no right turn, no straight on, and no U-turn. And we also here need to compute a confidence level that is based on the number of traces. Because in some situation also here we get some false positives and somehow need to separate the better results from the one that might be a turn restriction or not. The results of these three components are available via the Improve OSM tools. Currently, we have three main tools. We have the web tool. The web tool is available via that link. We have a JOSM plugin for these three components, and we also have an ID. The ID was developed in the last couple of months. So now I will show you a small video regarding the web application. Okay, here in the web application, we display a heat map for each of the three layers. And on the right side, you can see that we have also filter. You can filter out the map, filter out the status, and the one-way confidence, missing road type, and also the turn restriction confidence. In order to be able to edit in this tool, you need to be logged in with your OSM ID, and to see the actual missing attributes, you need to zoom in to a street level view, as shows the example. And at the street level view, for example, for the missing roads, the tiles will be shown. The tiles are colored based on different color. Okay, our next tool is the ID tool. In the ID, we took a different approach, and instead of showing a heat map, we show clusters, as in the case of the JOSM plugin. We use three different colors: red for missing roads, blue for turn restriction, and yellow for one-ways. On the left side, you can see there is also an Improve OSM panel. Here you can filter out the results and even filter out to see only, let's say, one-ways or only missing roads. And also in this tool, in order to see the actual elements, you need to zoom in a lot. And after the map is displayed, street level map, the one-way element will be highlighted. And also here you can see details of the selected element. So the next tool is the JOSM plugin. Here you can see that we use the same visualization as in the case of the ID, and we display clusters instead of the heat map. Here we have three layers: missing roads, turn restriction, and traffic flow direction. And for each layer, we have a different set of filters. Also here, in order to see the actual missing elements, you need to zoom in. And on the right side, on the Improve OSM panel, you can see the elements of a selected item. And also from this panel, you have filter, comment, solve, and invalidate functionality. And now a short video regarding an editing workflow. In this case, the user starts to look up missing roads from the web application. In order to edit in JOSM, you need to have enabled the remote control plugin. And we kindly advise you to check, for example, the missing roads, check separate imagery layers to be sure that the elements are actually missing, because otherwise you will end up to add something that maybe it's not valid. And if you find elements that are invalid, please mark as invalid. And after you edit the item in the map, it is a good idea to also close it via the Improve OSM plugin, the tiles. And in the JSON plugin, via the setting, you can also enable or disable some of our layers. Let's say you want to focus only to missing roads and you didn't want to see all the time the other two layers. Here are some statistics regarding our detection. As you can see, we detect most missing roads, and also the missing roads are mostly solved by the community that is followed by the traffic flow direction. And for turn restrictions, we have only a few of them solved, but this is mainly because it is much more harder to add a turn restriction than a missing road or missing house. Okay, so currently we are still developing our Improve OSM components, and our next steps will be first to create map roulette challenges for the Improve OSM data, add more new fresh data so you guys will have more places to edit that are missing from the map. We are also working on enhancing our algorithms by applying machine learning. And soon the ID tool will replace our web application. I think it will be around 2 months, if I'm not mistaken. And after that, we will have only the ID tool and the JSON plugin. And of course, we are still adding new features to the JSON plugin. Okay, this is only a short announcement. We will have also an OpenStreetView presentation tomorrow around 10. And we have also a booth, and please stop at our booth. Any question? Maybe if some of your question, what are we using for processing? We using for data storage, Hash-based and HDFSA, and for data processing, Hadoop and Spark. And this is all. If you have any question, feedback, or new feature, please write either via the Improve OSM plugin GitHub or via the Missing Roads feedback page. Thank you.
Thank you, Beata. Again, to get back on time, I'm afraid we can only take one or two questions. And may I kindly ask our third speaker to come down and put his slides on the laptop while doing so. Thank you. So, questions? No question at all? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so that was super exciting what is possible. It sounds like it depends a lot on where Telenav is operating. I was just wondering sort of what are the statistics on where and how many cars you're on and things like that.
I can show later you some statistics via the Improve OSM tools, but Telenav has, via its Scout application, integrated also the old Scobbler, so we basically have data also in Europe and also in America, and we have also in South America, and basically the other places where our users goes. But later on I can show you if you are interested in a country or something like that.
Another question? We have time. No question? Last word? No? Okay, well then, thank you again, Beata.